हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज दिव्या गोयल। वेलकम टू माय चैनल क्रिएटिव स्टडी विद कोडिंग, वेयर वी लर्न सी कोडिंग इन एन इफेक्टिव वे फ्रॉम डे वन। इन दिस वीडियो वी लर्न स्विच, ब्रेक, कंटिन्यू एंड गो टू। इफ यू वांना मेक मेन्यू लाइक प्रोग्राम, वे मल्टीपल चॉइस इज गिवन एंड यू कैन चूज एनी वन एट अ टाइम, यू नीड टू यूज स्विच स्टेटमेंट। लाइक देर आर थ्री चॉइसेस गिवन, 1, 2, 3, एंड वी कैन यूज एनी वन ऑफ देम एट अ टाइम। Let's suppose if I choose number 1, that is half pyramid of star, it will show the output of half pyramid of star. Next time if I choose number 3, that is natural number series, it will show the output of natural number series. And if I choose number 2, that is for even or odd, it will show the output of even or odd. So let's learn what is switch. When we want to make menu-like program having multiple options, switch is used, where one value is associated with each option and you need to choose only one at a time. This is the syntax of switch. First of all, the expression in switch evaluates and then compares to the values present in different cases. It executes that block of code which matches the case value and break the code block. If there is no match, then default block is executed. If we don't use break statement at the end of each case, program will execute all consecutive case statements until it finds next break statement or till the end of switch case block. Now this is the program of switch case statement, where ch is an integer that refers choice which has passed as an expression inside switch parenthesis, and program will execute while choice not equal to 4 means it will execute 3 times. And in case first, the code of half pyramid of star is written, you may see it clearly. And in case 2, code of even or odd is written. And in case 3, code of natural number is written. This expression matches all the three cases given in the program. Let's see how does it work. So see the whole program written here. So compile and run it. First of all, you may see the output is menu-like program. If I choose 1, that is ch will be 1. And it matches the all case values and it finally matches the case 1. Because ch is 1, so it will show the output of 1. Next time if I choose number 2, that is ch will be 2. And it will show the output of even or odd number. And finally if I choose number 3, ch will be 3 here and it will show the output of natural number series. If I choose 4, choice is compared to all case values. Since it doesn't match any of case values, so it will execute default case. And it will print you've entered wrong choice. Now let's learn break statement. Break statement ends the loop or block of code immediately when it is encountered. And the syntax of break is break and semicolon. The break statement is used inside loops or switch statement. The break statement breaks the loop one by one in the case of nested loop. Thus, it breaks the inner loop first and then proceeds to outer loop. The break statement is used with if statement inside the loop given below. Now, let's understand it with an example. Now, this is a program for printing natural numbers. But when it becomes 10, it will break the loop and print the output. So we'll have to give a condition. If I equal to 10, it breaks the loop. So it will print from 1 to 9 only. To learn loops, refer the channel. Now let's understand it with another example. In this example, we are entering 10 values and printing its sum. But if user enters a negative number, it will break and will show the output. Now compile and run it and get the output. You can see if I enter a negative value, it is not added to the result due to break statement. Now let's learn continue. The continue statement skips the current iteration and continues with the next iteration. The syntax is continue with semicolon. The continue statement is used with the if statement in loops. You may see as it given below. Now this is a program for continue statement. where 10 numbers are entered and its sum will be shown. But as soon as user enters a negative number, it skips it and continues with next iteration and shows the result. Now compile and run it. Here I am entering 10 numbers including negative numbers. And continue will skip the negative numbers and print the sum of rest of the numbers. Now let's learn go to statement. The go to statement allows to transfer control of the program to the specified level, and its syntax is go to that particular label name and label with its statement. Now let's understand it with an example. Here 10 numbers are being entered and its sum is being calculated. But when a user enters negative number, go to statement allows to transfer control of the program to the specified level. Here at label D, average of numbers has been specified. So it will show sum and average of the numbers. Now compile and run it. And see the output over here. You can see here calculating sum and average. Thank you so much for watching the video, and keep watching such valuable videos. Do subscribe the channel, like and comment in comment section, and share it as many as possible so that your friends can also learn it.